We've been looking a lot recently at dependency injection, and last week I showed you dependency injection in a simple Angular application. And what I promised to do this week was take that one step further, because we know that one of the big benefits of dependency injection is that you can then use it for unit testing and swap between injecting a real object to injecting with a mock object. So that's what we're going to do here. So let's just have a quick recap at what we had last time. So this was our application, and if I just run that up. And so we have there on the first page just our list of book titles with multiple ratings for each title. And then when we went to summary, we can see we've got these aggregations. So we're getting the average rating from the previous page of all of those titles. And that was done with two services. We had the one service called the Review Repository Service, which was how we got hold of our data. That's a bit of a cheat anyway, because we're actually mocking the data there. Really, we should have been getting it from some kind of web service, but let's not worry about that. That's what we've got there. But then we had our Review Summary Service, which did that work of taking that data, aggregating it into those summaries. And as I mentioned last time, whenever you create any kind of item using Angular, you get generated with it an equivalent spec file. So we've got our review summary component. We've got our review summary component.spec. Similarly for our services. Similarly for the main application as well. We've got one in there. And these are where we put the tests. And to start with, it just gives us some very simple tests like a creation test. This actually uses a library called Jasmine, which is a very widely used JavaScript and TypeScript unit testing library. And basically, so there we've got, this describes the whole collection of tests we're going to have on the summary service. So with describe, we've got a before each. So that's code that gets run before each and every test, because we want each test to run in isolation. And then we've there got just the first test, the kind of sanity check. Can this object actually be created? And so that service is getting hold of our book review summary service, the thing we want to test, and then just testing like that. If we want to run that up, then all we have to do is at the command line, ng for Angular again, and then test, and that will actually run up all of those tests and launch a browser to show us what's going on. And there you can see basically it's giving us five tests, just the creation test for each one of the components it's got in there, and they're green lights because those are obviously passing. If I were to put a deliberate failure, so let's say change that to be null, which it's not going to be, but that's another thing you can test for. Again, just need to save that and the whole thing will build again. And we can see it's got the failure in there. And if again we look in here, we can see there it's telling us we've got that failure, expected it to be null when it was something. So similar to what we've seen with XUnit and other testing environments in the .NET world, just obviously a different technology. So what we want to do now is we want to start testing the actual functionality of our book review summary service. And it's only got the one interesting property in this case, rather than a method, which is that review summaries. So that's what we're going to test. So we're going to put in here another test. So as well as it should be created, we're going to have one called it should calculate correct averages. And then that should have the code to test for that. Now, in order to calculate the averages, it obviously has to have a set of data to manipulate, which when this application is running properly, is the data it gets from the book review repository service. Now, as I said, really that should be coming from a web service somewhere. But the point is, if we want to test our summary service to make sure it's doing the calculation correctly, we want to be in complete control of the data that we're dealing with. We don't want it to come in from another service, certainly not one that's connected to the web. And so for that reason, we want to do some mocking. We want mock data that we're completely under control of. And that's really where services come into their own. Because although we're testing the book review summary service, so we definitely want to be running that code, we are not testing the book review repository service. In fact, we want to remove that from the equation. And so that's the thing that we're going to mock. So back in our summary service tests, I'm going to create a mock repository service. So let's do that. The way we do that is we can just up the top here, I'm going to say const, and then I'm going to call this my mock book review repository service. And then, just like in the .NET world, we would use a library such as mockU for helping us to generate mock objects. Jasmine, the library we're using here, actually has that built in. So I can say equals jasmine.create spy obj, that's what it's called. And then we can use a generic, so we're going to go for the book review repository service. So that's not the class that we're testing. We're testing the book review summary service. This is the one that we want to mock. And then the other thing that we do in there is we provide a list of the methods that we want to mock. Now, we know the only method we've got on there is get reviews. Okay, so that was the method that we've got listed there. So we're trying to mock that. And to make that work, we need to provide some mock data. So let's just do that. Let's just in here say const mock reviews and then equals, and then that's going to be array, which will just give a type of book review array. And then let's just put a few dummies in there. So we'll have title is going to be book one. So no attempt at reality in terms of names and things. We'll give it a rating of 5. And then we'll have a second review that is also going to be for the same book. So book one again, and give this one a 1. And then we'll just have a third review, but this time for a different book. So book two can have a rating of 4. So that should be enough sample data so that we know what's going on. But what do we do with those mock reviews? Well, they are what we put in here on the mock object. So we're mocking this book review repository service and saying when someone calls get reviews, don't give them back the real data, just give them back the mock data we've got there. Then down here, we need to actually assert that the summary component is behaving correctly. Now remember, the main thing that we have here is we have our summaries. So let's just say const summaries equals, and then service, which remember was what we had here, that's our summary service. So service.reviewSummaries, that will just give us back the results. And then we're going to have some tests. So we do that with an expect. So that's our main tool in Jasmine for saying that we expect the result to be this. If it is this, we get a green light. If it's not what we expect, we get a red light. And I'm simply going to say summaries. And then we can do a to have size. And in this case, we expect it to have size of 2, because although we've got 3 books, we've only got 2 distinct books. And remember, the summary just gives us 1 entry for each distinct book. So we'll have 1 for book 1, 1 for book 2. So that's what we're going to have in there. And then we can do a few others if we want to be really thorough. We can have an expect and then summaries entry 0.title should be book 1. And then we could have rating to be, and then the 2 that we gave for there are 1 and 5, so the average of that is 3, so that's what the average should be. And then for the second one, we expect that to be book 2, and that only had the 1, so that's going to have a rating of 4. And so now if we save that, it will again rerun the tests, and we're getting a failure. And if we take a look at the results, we can actually see typical sort of thing you see if you get this wrong in this way. Hang on, it's talking about Dr. No and Emma and persuasion. We've clearly not quite got this right, because we're having injected the real book review repository with those real books rather than the mock data that we put together over here. So something going wrong there. And the thing that's going wrong is, although I've created this mock book review repository service, you can see from the fact that it's in grey that I've never used it. I haven't actually done the important bit of work. And so because of the way we set up the service originally, basically because we say provided in root, It is provided by default both when we run the application, which is what we want to happen, but also when we run the test, which is what's happening here, and we don't want that to happen. So we need to actually change that behavior. So back in our summary test code, in here, although there's not much in there, this is where we put our configuration. So this configures the testing module. And if we want to do any mock injection of services, which is what we want to do here, we put in here a section called providers, which is going to be an array of entries. We've only got one of them here because it's a simple case, but you can imagine there could be more than one. And then for each entry, we put in a curly brace and we say provide, and then the class that we want to change the behavior of. So in this case, it's our book review repository service. And then we say the value that we want to replace that with. So we say use value, and then that is where we actually put the object. And so what we're essentially saying here is whenever anybody asks for a book review repository service, don't give them one, which would be the default behavior. Instead, give them a mock object. And so in our review summary service constructor, when we run this in testing, it will get our mock object. And so having done that, now when we do our save, then we can see we're getting green lights. If we look at the code, we've got green lights, and we can see there particularly should calculate correct averages, has worked correctly. So that was the second half of our dependency injection in Angular. One of the big reasons we have dependency injection is so that when we're doing unit testing, we can start injecting mock objects and isolate the class under test. So in this case, it was the summary component that was the class under test. Therefore, we wanted to mock the repository component because we didn't want to get real data. We wanted to be in complete control. So as I mentioned in the previous video, which was our first look at Angular, I'd be really interested to know if Angular is something you want to know more about. So do let me know. There's lots more that could be said about it. It's a huge environment. I have to say, coming from a C-sharp background, it is a bit different for me. It's not as strongly typed. It's not quite as comfortable for someone with my background. But since I've also got something of a background as a JavaScript programmer, it's an absolute joy to be using something like TypeScript and Angular, which gives you so many more errors as you're writing and building the code rather than just at runtime. So, hope you enjoyed that. Do let me know if you did. Do subscribe, do click the like button, and I'll see you next time.